Guys, today we're going to do a little bit of a revisit of these fantastic little displays, the Nokia 5110. You might have Arduino projects or ESP8266 projects or Raspberry Pi or whatever that you need to have a human interface, you need to have a little display. This little display is one of my favorites, has been for years. It's a good old standby, it's tough as nails, and it just works. So today, let's do a little revisit.
Okay, so back to the bin. You guys have seen this before. I keep many of these, and this one is the one where I have some displays. We've got these OLEDs and this large TFT, but today we're interested in the Nokia 5110s. As you can tell, it's one of my favorite displays. I have a ton of them. We'll go ahead and grab an Arduino Nano, and we'll hook it up. Okay, I've saved some time and gone ahead and hooked it all up. It's SPI communication to the Arduino Nano. I'll put the pin locations right on the screen for you, as well as they're documented quite well in the readmes for my sample code, which is just the Adafruit libraries with a few modifications. I'll post all my GitHubs down below. They're kind of spread out. I should amalgamate all the 5110 stuff, but I haven't yet. Anyway, everything will be right there for you. You can go ahead and fire it up. This is just with the Adafruit example code. With one exception, I've added the backlight circuit on, which you can hardly see here. But if I turn the light off a little bit, you can see that a lot better. Pretty cool. Once our code gets up and running here, you can see it goes through a bunch of different line draw examples, various other things that Lady Ada and team have programmed in just to show off what their library can do with some clever coding. It works amazing. There are other libraries for the Nokia 5110s, but I really like the Adafruit ones just for simplicity's sake, and they do really well with text. Here's all the text in emojis, different styles of text. You can rotate, and then you can do different draw stuff, and they go through a bunch of different star animations. Animations on the 5110, well, remember the age of this thing. This is about what you get. It's not perfect. It's not like a OLED display or the really high refresh stuff that we're used to nowadays, but for Arduino projects, it just works amazing. Now, with my example code flashed to it, we should be able to do an analog read off of pin 0, and we should be able to react with that by just touching the pin with my hand. And you can do really fast reads of the pin, plot it out, do whatever you want, but this gives you an example of just basic text on the screen. There's nothing to it. Code's linked below. Now let's say you wanted to do something with some graphing and maybe make a little mini oscilloscope. Well, I've got you covered here too. Code link down below. I did a really basic oscilloscope of sorts. You can see it picking up the noise in the room. There's no graduations on this because it's super basic code. But if I go ahead and take my finger and touch the input pin, you can see we get a reaction on the scope. And we're able to plot voltage over time, which is really, really cool. You can put a voltage divider on this on the input, make yourself a really, really simple graphic display for voltage values or current values or whatever you'd like to measure. These things are really, really handy, and I love, look at the viewing angle. You can still see this nearly flat to the display. The phones were great that way. They're tough as nails. They're fairly cheap. The only drawback is the extensive number of pins because it is using SPI instead of what I love, the I2C displays. Small price to pay for something quite so durable, quite so useful. Wonderful little units. I really, really love them. I hope you use these in your projects. Links are all down below. Let me know if you're using the Nokia 5110s. Next video, I think we're gonna show off the new full color SPI replacement for this. Approximately the same size, but full color display. I'm looking forward to it. See you guys next video.